What does Gilby make of all this? Is Gilby fitting in well in the group? Is he like totally assimilated by now?
Oh, Gilby, let me tell you a little story about Gilby. He had 3 weeks to learn 50 songs, right, before we came out. And we started in Boston. And I was really nervous for Gilby. I'm like, Gilby, okay? He was right before the gig, the first gig. He's like, yeah, why? And I'm nervous. And Slash going, Gilby, is everything going to be okay? And he's like, yeah, it's fine. Why? Would you guys, you know, settle down? Gilby takes everything, you know, he's so mellow about everything. Yeah. And he's such a good player. And he's very confident.
Yeah.
So, you know, Gilby, what does Gilby think of this whole thing? He's like, cool, can I have a sandwich? You know? Hi, Jeff. See ya.
We're in RFK in Washington, D.C., and right now here with Gilby Clarke of Guns N' Roses. I want to remind you, at 9 p.m., special, Guns N' Roses, past, present, and future. And you're part of the present and future of Guns N' Roses. And it's got to be like a trip for you to be taken kind of, I'm not saying from nothing.
It was nothing,
but taken
though.
from doing okay in L.A. And now to be put in like the biggest rock and roll band in the world.
Basically, they bribed me. They made me do it.
Yeah, it was a real tough
it was
one,
a
right?
Real tough decision, you know, to go from the clubs and stuff to doing this. It was hard.
And is it pretty much a trip? I mean, it's, you know, you didn't really have to go through that process. I mean, Gilby, I know you've been in a lot of other bands and had to go through the process of trying to climb up the ladder, but you went basically from here to like there in one day.
10 years of struggling, 6 months of cheating, and just right there to the top.
Has it been pretty wild? Been a roller coaster?
Oh man, this is great. This is like everything you've ever heard of, like the Rolling Stones used to do back when we were growing up. This is it. This is the top.
Well, right now, let's play a video that you got to be your first Guns N' Roses video in, pretty much.
Yeah, it was my first one.
And my first Guns N' Roses video.
That's right. You were the co-star, right?
Oh, sure, Gilby. Here's November Rain, Guns N' Roses.
Going from some sort of obscurity to such a huge band and then seeing the photos.
Well, it was nice that people actually wanted photos of me. I like that part. It's like it used to be, you know, begging people. It's like, please, please, put a picture of my band in. And they wouldn't do it. But now it's nice that they ask, you know. And, it's cool working with those guys because I can fuck with them, you know, when we're on stage and stuff, you know. Spit at them, shit like that.
Do you spit at Robert?
I spit at him all the time. I never hit him. I'm not that good, but...
And now that we have a daughter, you know, it's like she just kind of comes with us. It's like when we go out on the road, she's been on more tour buses than most kids, you know.
She took her first walking steps.
The last 5 years have sort of been a blur, you know, from like almost 3 years of touring with GNR, and then right into my record, and then right into Slash's record. It's like by the time I got home, it was like 5 years later, and I was a bit hungover. So I started working on some new songs, and this is what I got. To me, it's, you know, just a good old-fashioned, you know, rock and roll record. The guitars are loud, it's got a lot of energy. Might not be fashionable right now, but it's got a good spirit. It's not that much of a change, but it is more direction. Like I said, on the first record, from what I do on my own, you know, when I'm playing guitar and singing, I like rock, I like pop, I like blues, you know. So I have like a lot of different styles that I enjoy and that I like to play. So on the first record, each song was like one of those, you know, and it was very diverse. And I actually wanted it that way. But when I did this record, I kind of took everything that I enjoy and put it into every song. So you hear a little bit of rock, a little bit of pop, a little bit of blues in every song. So therefore, I mean, to me, like I said, it's just rock and roll. It's just straight ahead. If it's good enough for rock and roll, well, it's good enough for me. If it's good enough for rock and roll, well, it's good enough for me. When I'm writing songs, I always start on the guitar first and, you know, get kind of something going that's new or whatever. But lyrically, I'm always writing, I write from like an observer's point of view. You know, I don't really write about, you know, myself and, you know, I don't feel good today and, you know, I gotta go see my therapist or whatever. I don't have one, but I tend to write from an observer's point of view of, you know, what's going around and stuff, kind of point things out and kind of like raise a lot of questions in my songs and stuff. And not a lot of times do I, you know, give the answers. It just kind of gives people something to, you know, listen to and think about and stuff like that.
Yesterday wasn't great. Stayed in bed in my hangover clothes. I couldn't get up for the day. Wasn't yesterday great.
It has to be fun. I mean, you know, this is one of the things that we have left in what we do is you have to enjoy this, you know. And when we go into the studio and make the record, that's the most important thing to me is you get all the guys together and we're there because we like to play. And, you know, it's just on your mark, get set, have fun. You know, just play loud and just really, you know, just enjoy it. And as soon as we got a good one, you know, put on tape and there you go. You get 11 of them and you got a record, you know. Try to keep it as simple as that. And it really can be that simple if you want.
With Guns N' Roses, Gilby had the chance to play the way he'd always wanted to, giving him the confidence to go solo.
What was really nice about playing with the guys is there's a lot of aggression in their music, and once again, it is simple. It is like, you know, rock, but maybe it's hard rock, you know, but I like the way that they approached it. It was just very aggressive, and it was the way that I've always wanted to, you know, make records and play live. So what it did was it kind of just gave me a little bit of confidence when I started going out on my own to, you know, to